Hello guys. Today's lesson is about artboards. The artboard is called the live area because any objects placed on that artboard will output to the chosen output device or be exported with your final file. So this white screen that you see here is your artboard. This gray area surrounding the white artboard is called the pasteboard. This is where you can place objects, text, or other elements that you may not want to include within your final design, but still want to keep handy or use for reference. So remember that anything placed on the pasteboard won't be included when you export or print your Illustrator file. So basically, it's a handy space for organizing and storing elements without cluttering your main artboard. A document can have multiple artboards of a uniform size or of different sizes. For example, you could create a document with customized artboards that each contain a business card, a logo design, a resume, or a brochure for a client identity package. Using the Illustrator Artboard tool, you can edit your artboards at any time. You can either pick the tool from the toolbar or use the shortcut Shift-O to activate it. When you choose this tool, you enter Artboard Mode, which is represented with the blue dotted lines all around, along with the handles, and can help you manage your artboards. You can resize the artboard using one of the handles at the corner of the artboard. You can even resize it using the controls on the right, which we will get to in a moment. On the View menu, select Smart Guides to show on-screen alignment guides. When I resize my artboard, it shows me the X and Y values with the Smart Guides on. Now let's turn it off. And when I resize the artboard, the values are not shown anymore. You can even open the artboard panel by choosing Window and then Artboards. In this panel, you can see all your artboards listed. You can individually pick the artboards and click on the preset drop-down menu to update their size. Double-clicking on the artboard's number will locate it and make it your active artboard. Double-clicking on the name will allow to rename the artboard. Double-clicking on the artboard icon will open the artboard options. Click on the new artboard icon at the bottom of the panel to create a new artboard. Click on the name of the artboard, then click on the trash icon at the bottom of the panel to delete it. The up and down arrows in the artboard panel will move your artboard in the sequence, so although it will not move them digitally, it will change their order in sequence. Option or Alt and roller button on the mouse will help you zoom out to view all the artboards and zoom in as well. You can even use Command and Minus key on a Mac or Control and Minus key on a PC to zoom out to view all the artboards. To zoom in, use the Command and Plus key on a Mac or Control and Plus key on a PC. The control panel will display settings and options related to artboards. So most of what you can do using the artboards panel, you can do using the control panel as well. If you're using Essentials Classic workspace, you can find the control panel on the right and even on top. Clicking the link icon will allow you to increase or decrease the size of the artboard, keeping the uniformity intact. Unlinking the button will allow you to customize the length and width as per your preference. At any point to exit artboard mode, press Escape or select a different tool. You can rename the artboards from here as well, so let's name this one business card. and then click the small plus button to add another artboard next to it, which will default to the size of the previously selected artboard. You can customize the size of this artboard using the preset drop-down list. So let's say I don't want this artboard in the letterhead size. I can always change it to a B4 size and name it poster. I can always change the orientation of the artboard by clicking the portrait button here. To move the artboard, click anywhere inside the artboard and drag it to the desired location. Holding shift while dragging it will allow me to drag it smoothly without any lateral movements. See what happens when I just click and drag without holding shift. There are chances that my artboard could move laterally, which I don't want. Now let's say I want to make a copy of the artboard. So all I need to do is click anywhere inside the artboard and then hold shift and option on a Mac, or shift and alt on a PC and then drag, and it shall copy the artboard with the same dimensions. Now let me draw a shape here on this artboard. If I want to move this artboard along with the shape, I'm going to check this box which says move artwork with artboard, and then click anywhere inside the artboard, hold shift and then drag the artboard, and the artboard will move along with the artwork inside it. If you want to just move the artboard and not the artwork it holds, uncheck the box that says move artwork with artboard, and only the artboard will move, leaving the artwork behind. The artboard options button has pretty much the same options that are already there in the properties menu of the artboard, plus a few extras, as you can see. So feel free to explore them when required. Rearrange all option allows you to rearrange your artboard in different number of columns or rows depending upon the layout options you choose. You can even specify the spacing between each artboard for a cluttered-free document. To switch to a particular artboard, select the number of the artboard from the panel at the bottom, and that shall become the active artboard. To delete an artboard, you need to have the artboard tool selected and then either click the delete or backspace button on the keyboard and the artboard shall be gone. You can even use the trash icon in the properties menu or the trash icon on the top menu to delete an artboard. So guys, that's all about artboards in Adobe Illustrator. All right, so we're going to stop here. And in the next lesson, we're going to explore two of the quick navigation tools as they'll help you get proficient in Illustrator. So ensure to watch the next one. Until then, goodbye and thanks for watching.